are living in unique times. Disasters of nature have caused destruction and havoc in many places, and the losses are so great they can't be measured. The economy keeps inflating, and sickness and disease are taking many lives still and leaving devastated hearts. Depression, anxiety, and suicide are affecting people of every age and race. The pressures of everyday life are getting stronger every day, and many people are getting weaker. And violence is running rampant. Homelessness and poverty are increasing like never before. Many are wondering, are we near the end of times? Yet with all of the negative things happening, there's also a new strength coming to people. Men and women whose trust is in the Lord are actually thriving. Yes, the Bible speaks of a falling away from faith in God in the last days, but it also speaks of an outpouring of the Holy Spirit reserved for the last days. This latter rain that the scripture speaks about is a refreshing anointing available to whoever wants it. We can choose to live in fear, doubt, anxiety, and grief, or we can choose life. God has given many gifts, like a beautiful sunrise, a beautiful sunset, friends and family that love us, pets that are dependent on us, rest, colors, flowers, smells, vegetation, oxygen, water, food, the ability to communicate, and so much more. The greatest gift that God has given us is His love. The gift of salvation, which includes forgiveness and eternal life, is free to whoever receives it. It was expensive, yes, but God Himself paid it by the sacrifice of Jesus on the cross. God loves all races and genders, and the young and old alike. He shed His love on us, and we are to express that love to each other. Philippians 4:8 says, "Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about these things." Think of the good things. Focus on what you have, some of which may not have a lot of monetary value, but are worth much, much more. Be thankful for these things and give God praise. So today, Lord, I choose to be thankful to You for so many blessings on my list. I will not let lack or fear, doubt, bondage, or the words of negative people blind me to the things You have given me. I choose to think on the good things and give You praise. Thank You for Your help. Thanks for being with me on the mountaintops of accomplishment, and thanks for walking with me through the valley of shadow of death. Your word says in Romans 8:37-38, "No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels or demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord." Let the praises to God rise from your heart. If you're hearing this, then you have something to be thankful for. Give thanks with a grateful heart to a God who may be invisible to the carnal eye and may seem to be silent to the natural ear, yet He does His best work behind the scenes. You're still here. He must be looking out for you. You can't outrun His love. Give Him thanks.